Dubai, fondly known as the city of skyscrapers, has perhaps witnessed one of the fastest real estate growth. And our guest today watched Dubai rise into the sky as she grew up in a family whose real estate credentials date back to as long as 1961. As they say, one woman's success will always help another woman's success. And these successful journeys of the powerful and strong woman will act as milestones for generations to come. In our show, Women of Substance, organized by Khaleej Times and led by Cetaphil, we are celebrating and saluting many such living legends. Our guest today is a businesswoman and philanthropist from Dubai. She's currently the managing director of retail at Easa Al Gurg Group. She presides over as a member of board of directors for a lot of other companies and non-profit organizations. She's also the chairwoman of Young Arab Leaders since 2008. A keen member of UNHCR, she truly defines what professional versatility is all about. Let's welcome the very multifaceted Muna Al Gurg. Hello, Muna. Welcome to our show.
Thank you.
Pleasure having you here today with us. You know, what I want to first understand is that when was it that you realized your passion for business, or rather, when was it that you thought, oh, you know, now is the time that I want to step into my family business and I want to take this forward?
I had just studied business administration at university. I had a concentration in marketing and advertising. I really found my forte in terms of creativity. And I had worked for a while outside the business in an advertising agency. And I realized that there was a lot of value that I could add to the business.
Was it always business that you had in mind, not necessarily family business, but something of your own kind that you thought you would want to set up?
I actually never thought of setting anything up on my own. I studied business because I felt perhaps that's something that would be of interest to me. I really dabbled, and you know how it is when you're young.
Yes.
You dabble with things.
So we'd like to understand this in more detail, the whole structure and hierarchy of your business. What is it like, which all companies are there, and what all do you sort of manage, and you how do you think after you've joined the business has grown?
So I've been working in the business for the last 15 years. So everything from, let's say, operationally the store, right up to customer service, marketing, social media, digital, everything falls under me with the retail business.
Okay.
I'm also on the board of the group with my two sisters. So that's quite unique in terms of being three sisters.
Three sisters,
on the board. I mean, I certainly feel that when women have role models to look at, they strive to kind of be better in their lives and they can achieve their dreams. And I think that within the UAE, our family business is quite unique from that perspective, with three women. And you know, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, our ruler, always speaks about women's empowerment.
Yes.
I think that the exposure is there and people get exposed to it and do look up to something like that, particularly women who feel, you know, they ask questions about, you know, what they would like to do in their lives.
Right. You know, speaking of which, in fact, that you mentioned your sister and we believe Dr. Raja Al Gurg is somebody that you've gone on record to say is a role model for you, somebody that you personally really look up to.
Right. Well, my sister actually started in the education sector. So her background was not business. What I admire most about her is that she's been in the business for far longer than me. And her success and her ability to manage her personal life with her success in the business and in the business world is impeccable.
Speaking of work-life balance, was it something that you always derived from her, or was it something that you followed on your own and, you know, you had your own ways of dealing with it?
I think that I've always found it important to have that work-life balance. Mm-hmm. And so, again, when my daughter was growing up, I did not compromise on my time with her.
Right.
I made sure that I planned my day where basically I was with her mm-hmm. at the important hours mm-hmm. of the day, mm-hmm. although I was working during the
yes.
day.
So how old is your daughter, Mona?
So my daughter now is actually 24, mm-hmm. and she's a civil engineer, and she works on 3 project sites in Dubai.
Yes. When women, you know, sort of decide to take up these kind of roles or get into such industries, families play an important role. Like,
they
you know, take an example of your daughter.
Yes.
She wanted to get into construction. So had it not been for your support,
correct,
she would not have been able to pursue it.
Yes.
So your thoughts on that?
Families and I would say social structure mm-hmm. and social norms mm-hmm, mm-hmm. really need to change. Mm-hmm. And this is my honest opinion on this. I feel that the government has done an impeccable job in mm-hmm. terms of getting more women to be part of mm-hmm. all sectors.
Right. Yes,
the social yes. norms are not exactly in line with that.
Right.
And so a lot of women go back home mm-hmm. and there are certain questions like, you know, why do you have to work these long hours?
Yes.
Why
yes.
do you have to take a trip abroad
yes.
for business?
Mm-hmm.
And I think that needs to change.
You know, we would also like to talk about your other roles that you have been playing in your life. Like, for instance, you are heading the Young Arab Leaders of UAE mm-hmm. since mm-hmm. 2008. You're the
correct.
Chairwoman. So how did that came along for you?
Well, the Young Arab Leaders again was launched at the Dead Sea by His Highness Sheikh Mohammed mm-hmm. and some other heads of states.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, we impact entrepreneurship, education in the region.
Mm-hmm.
And I was a member at the time,
mm-hmm.
and then I was invited to be part of the board.
Mm-hmm.
And so we kind of do a lot of work with young entrepreneurs.
Mm-hmm.
We have a lot of workshops in specific entrepreneurial-like
mm-hmm.
sectors.
Mm-hmm.
So. From that perspective, you know, thousands of youth
mm-hmm.
Within the UAE mm-hmm. are impacted by the Young Arab Leaders.
You are also a part of the United Nations High Commission for Refugees.
Correct.
How did you think of joining that? Or was it something that was offered to you? Or
yeah.
was it something that always interested you and you felt
yeah.
that, oh, you know, this is one section that I would like
yeah.
to work on?
Yeah. So in 2018, the UNHCR said they were forming the Middle East Board
mm-hmm.
for UNHCR
okay.
To help them, you know, with their work with refugees.
Mm-hmm.
And I was really invited to be part of this.
Okay. Okay.
We have already started working with them from a group perspective.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So at all our retail stores, at the point of cash,
mm-hmm.
basically you can donate money.
Donate, yes.
And also with our employees, they're
mm-hmm.
able to donate. So we have this communication going on within the group for the next 1 year, for
right.
example.
We believe that you also have launched a scholarship program in London School of Business.
Yes.
So what is all that about? Is it only for women? Or
yeah.
And is there a story behind it?
Yeah.
What is it that inspired
yeah.
you to some
yeah.
to start something of that
yeah.
sort?
So 10 years ago, I graduated from London Business School.
Mm-hmm.
I did an MBA.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to help more Arab women reach the C-suite level, corporate level,
right.
board level.
Okay.
And the way I could do that is by having my own scholarship for Arab
mm-hmm.
women.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And so I launched the scholarship a couple of years ago, and
okay.
now we are on to the third recipient of
oh,
the Mona Al Gurg scholarship.
Coming back to your business, so far, you know, mm-hmm. how do you think have you sort of, any business idea of yours that you think has helped the Gurg Group to attain a new height?
Mm. I think over the last 10 years, particularly if I were to talk from a communications perspective,
mm-hmm.
Bringing in digital, being at the top of the customer's mind in
mm-hmm.
terms of, let's say, particularly retail,
mm-hmm.
That has been something that I have really worked on.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that the group now is really on a quite a different level from that perspective.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Mm-hmm.
Amid all of this,
yeah.
you know, what is, or rather, how is it that Mona likes to unwind herself, you know, managing the work-life balance, the business empire, and being a part of so many other activities, CSR activities. How do you take a break from all of this?
Yeah. Well, I really take a break by, reading.
Okay.
So I love reading fictional books, mm-hmm. and I've always been an avid reader since I was young.
Yes.
I also, on weekends, I love to go to art exhibitions.
That's what I wanted to hear.
Because I collect contemporary Middle Eastern art.
Another thing that I would really like to touch upon that I'm sure not a lot of people are aware of is the fact that you're a fitness freak.
Yes.
How do you fit this in your schedule? Yeah.
I always manage to find time, mm-hmm. particularly as, you know, it's so important to be fit with age, mm-hmm. You know, look after yourself. Mm-hmm. And so over the last 2 years, I've started something that's very different, mm-hmm. Which is boxing.
Yes.
And I've really, really gotten into boxing. I enjoy it. Mm-hmm. It's a good cardio session. Mm-hmm. And also in the past, I've also started doing Pilates. So yes. I always make time, whether I'm tired or whatever it is. I make sure that I go to those sessions,
right.
Because it's so important. Your inner being, mm-hmm. should be healthy, and that really reflects on your thoughts, on everything.
Absolutely.
You know.
So Mona, you know, you've been a part of this huge business empire. Mm-hmm. Do you believe in yourself, in leaving a legacy behind?
I think it's crucial, mm-hmm. For people to think about what they leave behind,
mm-hmm.
Beyond their lifetime. Mm-hmm. And particularly if you've been quite fortunate, mm-hmm. with having a significant amount of wealth.
Mm-hmm.
It's our responsibility.
Absolutely.
To this world and
yes.
planet.
Yes.
So that's something that I keep thinking about, mm-hmm. all the time.
Mm-hmm. What is the philosophy that you particularly follow in your life? Anything that you'd like to share with our viewers with respect to how to, you know, continue with their journey, like with their struggle, let's just say, and try for the best?
Yeah, I think everybody goes through challenges and mm-hmm. struggles in mm-hmm. life. That's part of life, every mm-hmm. human being. Mm-hmm. What's important is to have a positive mind frame,
mm-hmm.
Pick yourself up, mm-hmm. and move on,
right.
and be positive about how you can always learn in life, and mm-hmm. how you can always improve yourself, mm-hmm. in life.
Right. Thank you so much, Mona, for being a part of this show taking us through your journey and making it such an enlightening session.
Thank you very much.
So much.
It was a pleasure to be with you.
Thank you.